this was our RC2014 Micro at the end of the last video. The board is now plugged into a backplane and mounted on the beginnings of a maker beam frame. What we're going to do today is to expand the maker beam frame and add a small power supply card kit. The power supply card is from Stephen C. Cousins and will give us more options in powering our system. The board is a low profile one with only a few components and does come with a well illustrated welcome guide. As always, we start with the lowest profile components first, namely the resistors. If you are adding this board to your RC2014 kit, you've probably had a bit of practice soldering already, but remember to take your time and check your solder joints as you go, as this saves a lot of time later should you have made a mistake. As we're going to use this board to power our RC2014 Micro, I've cut the link on the Micro that designated the power to come from the FTDI cable. This is our RC2014 now in its maker beam frame. This allows us to handle it quite easily and gives a bit of support to the main structure. What we're going to be doing now is we're going to be taking a new card and fitting it into here, the first slot. So here is our new card. This gives us more flexibility, as well as having an on-off switch at the left here, a reset switch. It also has a barrel jack to accept 5 volt input. And we also have a couple of pins where we can extend for an external reset switch. So we will plug this one in right at the front. And that is our board plugged in, sitting quite neatly at the front of the frame. And with our on-off switch, we can now control when the computer is switched on or off. Additionally, to test this unit, I'm going to add on another board we prepared in a previous video, which is this one. This is a 7-segment LED display. So we'll slot that into the next available slot. I have already cut the FTDI in the main board to allow us to power the system from this external board. And we're going to do that using one of these. This has a barrel jack at one end and a USB at the other. So if we plug this into the barrel jack, and we're going to be plugging it into one of these, a small 5 volt power bank. Plug this in and switch on. We now have the power bank operational. We can now switch the unit on by flicking the switch. And now we are running our entire RC2014 on battery power. Touch of the reset switch, and we can see quite easily when we hit reset, the reset LED is lighting up on the board. So now that we've got the power in place, we now have to add our cable to communicate with the main PC, which we'll now do. Here we are connected to our main computer. I set the RC2014 to boot straight into BASIC, and we're going to copy in a program we prepared in a previous video. And we can just paste this one straight in. And our application is now ready to run. So we can safely say that our new RC2014 with its backplane and power card is working successfully off batteries. As the Z80 processor and the RC2014 is a low power system, I expect to be able to run this off battery for quite some time. However, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.